Si el fracaso económico es solo debido al gobierno cubano, ¿qué sentido tiene el bloqueo?
In April 1960, a State Department memo proposed that the United States should deny money and supplies to Cuba to bring about hunger, desperation, and overthrow of government. In 1962, John F. Kennedy followed that advice, imposing a full trade embargo on Cuba. 60 years later, the embargo is still in place, and it's even more far-reaching. In Cuba, we call it the blockade. The blockade isn't just between Cuba and the United States, it's global. In 1992, the Torricelli Act blocked any ship that docks in Cuba from entering a US port for 6 months, and it banned foreign subsidiaries of US companies from trading with Cuba. Democratic Senator Robert Torricelli said the act was meant to wreak havoc on the island. 4 years later, Bill Clinton signed a law designed to stop foreign investment in Cuba called the Helms-Burton Act. Under Barack Obama, the US government began fining European banks billions of dollars for processing transactions involving Cuba and other countries. Donald Trump imposed an avalanche of sanctions, further isolating Cuba from the US and the rest of the world. If this wasn't enough, just before leaving office, Trump put Cuba on the state sponsors of terrorism list.
They're not Trump's regulations anymore, they're Joe Biden's.
Cuba is suffering stronger sanctions now than I think any other country, although it is of course no threat at all to the US.
Why don't companies and banks outside the US want to do business with Cuba?
The sanctions on Cuba, they act extraterritorially. European banks that won't touch a transaction, even if legal. I've counseled these banks that they're afraid of being fined and punished by the United States.